Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Doing the next topic called construction working of reciprocating pumps. I mean the double acting reciprocating pumps. We've seen what the how a single acting reciprocating pumps looks like. Now we'll see how a double acting reciprocating pumps looks like and the diagram and the working principle and the advantages of it. So as you can see, I have drawn a double acting reciprocating pump. Now let's first of all understand the difference between a single acting and a double acting pump. So single acting pump is the pump in which there is suction stroke at once, the water will be sucked, and in the next stroke the water will be pumped. So the discharge is not continuous. In one stroke it is getting pumped, in the other stroke it is getting pushed out. So you will not get a continuous discharge in a single acting pump. Whereas in case of a double acting pump, the suction and the discharge happens simultaneously. Suppose, as you can see in this diagram I've drawn, the piston will be at extreme left, suppose, and from extreme left it is moving to extreme right. So when it is moving to extreme right, the suction valve S1 will be opened, the water will be sucked in, and from the delivery valve D2, the water will be pushed out. So as you can see here, two things are happening simultaneously. The water is getting sucked and delivered at the same time. So when the piston moves from left to right, the S1 will be open, D2 will be open. From S1, the water will be pulled inside the pump because of the vacuum created. And at D2 will be open and the water that will be here will be compressed, and through D2 it will be delivered. So during the movement of piston from left to right, it is sucking water and it is delivering water. Now suppose the piston has reached extreme right. Now when it moves to extreme right to extreme left, now the suction valve S2 will be opened because of the vacuum created, and the water will be pulled inside the pump, and the water that had been pulled inside already before in the last stroke, now it will be compressed and the pressure will increase of this region, and the valve D1 will be opened and the discharge will take place continuously. So this is the difference between a single acting and a double acting. A single acting pump will give you a discharge in non-continuous manner, whereas a double acting pump will give you a discharge in continuous manner. So there will be a continuous output of water. It's not like what is coming, stopping. It will be continuously delivered to you. So this is the advantage of a double acting pump. Now what I have done is, what changes we've made is, there are two suction pipes installed. There are two delivery pipes installed. So since there are two suction pipes, there has to be two suction valves as well, S1, S2. There are two delivery pipes, there are two delivery valves, D1, D2. Now everything else is similar to the single acting pump. There is one piston, there is cylinder, there is piston rod which is welded to the piston. Then there is connecting rod which connects the crank with the piston rod. The crank is driven by a motor which rotates and in turn helps the piston to slide inside the cylinder. And the rest, everything else happens on its own, because the piston moves, the vacuum is created, and the water is pulled inside at some other place. The water is getting compressed, the delivery valve gets opened, the water is pushed out. So this is how the pump works like. So the delivery double acting pump, what it helps us in doing is, it gives you continuous discharge. So let's see graphically how the discharge pattern for a single acting and a double acting pump looks like. At rest, everything else is same. This is the crank, this is the connecting rod, this is the piston rod, this is the piston, this suction pipe, this two other suction pipe, these two other suction walls, this one has two. HS is a suction head, HD is a delivery head, delivery valve 2, this is a delivery pipe. So everything else is same, only the differences in construction, the little bit working is different. When the piston is moving, the suction and delivery is happening at the same time. Now let's see the graph of discharge versus the displacement. I've seen the sketch of it, how it looks like. Now we'll move on to the discharge pattern, the discharge behavior. We'll look through a graph and try and understand how double acting reciprocating pump is more beneficial when it comes to discharge and when it comes to looking at the output. So as you can see, this is the graph pattern for single acting pump. The discharge is along the vertical and the crank angle is along the horizontal. From 0 to 180 degree of crank movement, there is no discharge because there is suction taking place during that time. And when the crank moves from 180 to 360 degree, the water is getting compressed and it is getting delivered at the output. So during that time only you can see there is a discharge. Again, there will be same thing, there will be suction created. And then the next stroke, there will be discharge given. So this is how a pattern for a single acting pump looks like for discharge. So as you can see, this is not continuous. There is no discharge, there is discharge, there is no discharge. Again, there is discharge. So this is how it looks like. So for double acting, let's see how it looks like for a double acting cylinder. So in double acting, as you can see, there is no straight line pattern. Here the graph is, there's continuous discharge available at all the strokes, because in double acting, if in suction stroke also there is discharge, and in the discharge stroke there is also suction, so there is no gap anywhere. So this is how the discharge pattern looks like. So this is a continuous discharge. If you want to find the average of the discharge will be somewhere over here. This is the average discharge, as you can see somewhere the middle line. There'll be average discharge, and so you can calculate the average discharge as well. So that was all about the topic, reciprocating pumps, double acting. We've seen the working, we've seen the principle, we've seen construction, then we've seen the discharge pattern for both of them. I hope you've understood. Thank you.